Hi, I'm Dr. Ben Lindquist. Today I am joined by Drs. David Hao, Jason Lowe, and Sunny Patel to discuss some helpful telehealth tips in caring for patients during virtual visits. The objectives of this talk will be to discuss how to set up the virtual encounter, conduct a history, acquire vital signs, and complete a virtual physical exam. We will give a few tips on virtual patient care during COVID-19, and finally discuss some of the limitations of telehealth.
Telehealth is the practice of caring for patients remotely when the provider and patient are not in the same physical space. There has never been a more important time to use telehealth than during the COVID-19 pandemic, where telehealth can extend medical care to rural areas, preserve personal protective equipment, reduce the risk of transmission of disease, and protect patients and healthcare workers alike.
Let's begin with a case. Today, we have a 34-year-old male grocery store clerk who complains of cough and fever for 2 days. Dr. Lowe, how would you approach caring for this patient using telehealth?
Let's first talk about setting up the encounter with the patient. This requires some planning. Let's start with the obvious, which is often overlooked. Since this is a visual encounter, you'll want to ensure that your lighting is sufficient. Most camera sensors are small and need a lot of light to get a clear, detailed image. Here is an example of an interaction with insufficient lighting. Note the loss of details. More light is better. You should try to work in a brightly lit area with light aimed at your face. Avoid having lights behind you. This is called backlighting and can make your face look too dark. Make sure you ask your patient to move to a brightly lit area as well. Another key aspect that affects the quality of your visual presentation is where you put the camera in relation to your face. Try to place the camera at eye level so that you appear to be looking straight into it when you are talking to your patient. This serves to improve a sense of connection to whoever you are talking to. You should keep your entire head and upper shoulders in the frame. If you are too far, you appear distant. If you are too close, it can be very off-putting. The other aspect of the encounter is audio. It is very important that you find a quiet place to conduct your interview and exam. Most phones and laptops do not have great microphones or speakers. To maximize your experience, you should always try to ensure that you can hear your patient and that they can hear you. Here is an example of poor audio quality.
Hey there, Mr. Yen again. Can you hear me? This is Dr. Patel. Nice to meet you.
Hi, it's kind of hard to hear you.
I'm having trouble hearing you, sir.
It should be remembered that telehealth is simply a medium by which you can interact with a patient. It may add a layer of complexity to the encounter that needs to be dealt with to maximize the experience. Some interactions may have technical issues, which render the video poorly or not at all. Audio may also become an issue. To that end, it is recommended to speak slower than normal, with pauses between statements, in order for the listener to ask questions. Make an extra effort to enunciate words and avoid technical jargon.
Hi, I'm Dr. Nicole. Hi.
If the video quality degrades, consider switching to a voice-only or telephone interaction to minimize frustration. Voice interviews can offer sufficient insight to provide medical guidance.
Taking a careful history is paramount. Many diagnostic errors can be prevented by taking a thorough history. This is especially important when an in-depth physical exam cannot be performed via telehealth. While it may be challenging to establish a provider-patient relationship quickly through video, you have already been trained in eliciting patient histories. Do your best to maintain eye contact by looking at the camera. Be sure to inform the patient that you may be checking the patient's records on a separate screen or the same computer if you look away from the camera.
Hi, I'm Dr. Nicole. I'm sorry you're not feeling well today. So what's going on today?
I've got a bit of a cough and a fever the last couple days.
Oh man, I'm sorry to hear that. So tell me more about your cough.
It's been going on for the last couple of days. Kind of feels like it's getting worse. Feel like I'm starting to get a little short of breath and stuff. And then the fever, I've been taking some Tylenol, but just keep feeling hot and then cold.
Okay. Anything else you're experiencing right now?
Not a whole lot more, no. It's really just those two things.
Vital signs are still vital when seeing a patient via telehealth. Perhaps the most relevant vital sign for virtual visits with potential COVID-19 patients is the respiratory rate.
Okay, sir. If it's all right with you, I'm just going to observe you for a few moments.
Okay.
Okay.
You can observe respiratory rate by asking the patient to sit quietly for 15 seconds while you observe their breathing. Count the number of breaths and then multiply by 4. Do not tell the patient you are counting their breathing, as this will cause the patient to breathe abnormally.
You can also train the patient to calculate their own capillary refill. Instruct the patient to press firmly down on their finger and release as shown in this video. Count the seconds it takes for color to return to the finger.
One of the biggest misconceptions about telemedicine is that a physical exam is not possible. However, many aspects of the physical exam are possible to complete virtually. Looking at the general appearance of a patient like this one can help you decide on what type of care this patient may need. Dr. Patel, can you tell us what things you notice about this patient while looking at him?
Of course. He is breathing quickly, sitting upright with his hands on his knees. This is called tripod positioning. He is also using some of his accessory muscles to breathe, like his intercostal and abdominal muscles. This patient is clearly having increased work of breathing and would need immediate transfer to a hospital for further therapies. Other physical exam tips include recognizing speech patterns, such as if the patient is unable to speak in full sentences, as seen in this video.
Do you have any other medical problems?
I have a little bit of asthma, but it's usually not anything like this. This is not me. This is tough.
Or mental status changes, as seen in this video, with progressively declining levels of alertness indicating falling oxygen levels in the brain.
Are you still with me there? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, you look a little sleepy.
No, fine.
Okay.
Finally, you can also adequately assess the posterior oropharynx of your patient by having them or an assistant bring the camera closer with the light source, whether it is built into the device or external. These are just a few physical exam tricks you can use when virtually assessing your COVID-19 and other telehealth patients.
With vital signs and an observational physical exam alone, you can quickly identify which potential COVID-19 patients are in respiratory distress or look ill. Elderly patients are particularly at risk, especially when they also have comorbid conditions, such as cardiovascular disease, diabetes, hypertension, or chronic lung disease.
The main complaint to be aware of is shortness of breath, which may indicate a more severe presentation of COVID-19. Other high-risk complaints include chest pain, altered mental status, and intractable vomiting. Complications include respiratory failure or acute respiratory distress syndrome, ARDS, cardiac, thromboembolic, inflammatory, and secondary bacterial or fungal infections.
Concluding the visit is incredibly important. As with any encounter with a patient, it is important to provide excellent precautions and instructions to the patient. This includes reasons to visit a hospital or clinic, any medications to take, side effects to look out for, ways to prevent spread of illness like hand hygiene, mask use, and social distancing. Be sure to give the patient adequate time to ask questions to ensure that the plan is understood and the patient is comfortable.
So I've completed my assessment, and it seems like you have a minor respiratory illness. So this could include a COVID-19 infection, okay? The good news is that some people do not get much worse from this point. Of course, if your symptoms get any worse, please go to the nearest hospital as soon as you can, okay? Do you have any questions?
No, thanks so much, doctor. I really appreciate your help.
You're very welcome.
In caring for a patient virtually, you must understand the limitations of telehealth. High-risk patients and chief complaints often require in-person examinations. For example, if you are contacted to conduct a telehealth visit with an elderly person with fever and confusion, you identify that this is a high-risk patient and high-risk chief complaint that requires a clinic or hospital visit.
Understanding how to conduct a telemedicine exam has never been more important. Remember that planning for the encounter is essential, and taking a thorough history and virtual physical exam is possible. Thank you.